Hello and welcome to Embrace Eternity Podcast, co-hosted by Becca and Cass.
Where we talk about Mass Effect, Dragon Age, other games, and pretty much anything else we want to talk about.
Join us
and embrace eternity.
This episode will contain spoilers for pretty much all of Dragon Age. So, you've been warned.
Turn back now.
Play the games. Come back. Thank you. Today, we're going to be talking about DA4. Dragon Age 4. Sorry, or as the cool kids call it, DA4.
There's no information on it. It has not been confirmed. Nothing's been said about it. So, we're just going to fill in the blanks because we can.
Well, it's been certainly teased. The writers and the people who work on that project are not appearing to work on anything else at Bioware, but are still employed there. So, in my opinion, it's happening. Suspicious or just completely positively proof. And as to why they won't talk about it is that they have a weird fucking... They've been trying new shit, I think, with like how they promote their games. And I guess
They have a gag order.
Yeah, but like, I just don't understand saying that, oh yeah, we were successful. We're going to make another one. You know, you don't have to tell us the name. You can just be like, yeah, we're working on the next game. Because they are, but they just won't talk about it. Or say, yeah, it's happening. It's like, maybe it will happen. You never know if we tell another story. I'm like, okay, shut up. So we've heard from like voice actors who just like play the game in general, who worked on the project, that they like speculated, oh, well, isn't it going to be Interventor? Because, and I don't know if they're saying that because they have any knowledge and they're working on it. Because like, I don't think that would be violating a gag order to be like, oh, you know, I played it. So I would assume that we're going to the place that in the DLC we stabbed. So we're going to Interventor, which is what I think a lot of people think. I've talked about it a real bunch. And we were talking about previously, the possibility of continuing the Inquisitor story or not, with the way they wrapped up Trespasser, the assumption that they're not going to, because they've kind of been like, oh, in the years they retire, Cullen and whoever he's with, or whoever was with what, if you're with Solas, you're just fucking out there. I don't know. You're doing something. If you chose
crying.
To, yeah,
just
you're crying.
A lot.
It felt
or
like
punching a pillow.
Yeah, it felt like they were like concluding like the next fucking 10 years of the Inquisitor's life, which apparently doesn't include dealing with Solas or the shit that he reveals to you, which is confusing to me.
Doesn't make sense.
None of that makes sense. I don't.
Mm-mm. Nope.
Okay, let's talk about how we felt the Inquisitor's story ended and how we want or think they'll be included. And Liliana, she mentions if you're going to take on a protege. And I think that would be so fucking cool. I still love the Inquisitor. It would probably be kind of like just as brief as Hawk, though. Like, and then I get afraid, well, what if they kill him? And just recently replaying the main story from Inquisition, I was kind of noticing all the talk about Weishaupt. And I guess, does it always happen that the Grey Wardens split from Weishaupt? Like, they're like, well, we're not with you right now.
I'm pretty
like the
sure.
Ones that are not there, apparently, that some shit is going down with the Grey Wardens, more than just the calling. Yeah, so that's like a thing that I hadn't really considered in my speculation of how that story would be. Like, would we see the Warden?
I'd love
again?
To see the Warden, but it would be hard because you'd have to recreate them. I hope that we see our Inquisitor, though. I hope that, because I mean, since it's in the same engine, I would assume.
I hope so, too. We're never seeing Hawk again, though. We're never seeing him because, and the same goes for Alistair, because I hate to say it, because it pains me as someone, because I think both of us have obviously wardens that are with Alistair, mm-hmm. and maybe on the road with him. I love the Grey Warden and Alistair together, you know, doing their shit. That's the sweetest thing to me, so it pains me to say that, but whatever happens, I don't think will include him. Might include the Grey Warden, but since the Grey Warden could die, I don't see how that is really something they would even do. So no Hawk, no Grey Warden, our Grey Warden. There'd probably be other Grey Wardens. I hope so. Like, I wouldn't be disappointed.
Most of them are dead.
Could you imagine if an actual Grey Warden, like, showed the fuck up and was helping us and actually part of our team in the next game? That would be amazing.
I know. I was so disappointed that Blackwall wasn't actually one. And, like, I forget that he's even in the game. I'm sorry, Blackwall lovers. I forget about him.
Like, I should have included him on my list of ones that were, like... Because I don't even want to say that he's poorly done, because he's not. No. I think...
He's just easily, like, skipped. Like,
yeah, this last playthrough, I didn't even get... He didn't hate me, but he didn't like me, so he never did the thing where he went off to Valrio. He didn't. So, in the interest browser, he's just going to get a letter and he's dead.
Oh, God.
I hate that so much.
That feels sorry. Bad. Yeah, I just... He crosses my dash on Tumblr sometimes, and I'm like, oh, that's right. He's one of the companions. Oh, and then I feel bad, because it's not that he's a bad character or anything, or that I don't like him. It's just I forget that he exists, which I think is a failure.
Would have liked to have been there.
Yeah.
Would have liked to have seen it. Oh, God.
Yeah.
Oh, God, Blackwell, why are you such an asshole? No, he's not.
That, and after I saw his face without his beard, it really freaked me out. Well, and I was like, I can't. Yeah, I don't want to talk to you.
That was regrettable. But the one thing that really makes it really hard on me, because I played a character who was very, very much the stern inquisitor. Like, she was all about fucking getting it done. And he was, and he did the thing where he leaves, which I'd never had happen. And it's an intense, they played intense music. I think I told you about it at the time, but it was really scary. It was scary. The music was dramatic. And he was like, you're fucking awful. And I'm leaving. And it was scary. He's like, you don't care about anyone. I mean, Solas, when he's mad at you, they don't play that music. I mean, he hated my recent Inquisitor. And I didn't really feel bad about it, because I feel like the reasons for that aren't a solid. I don't know. I hate it when anybody hates you. Like, one time Cole left a character because I forgot to talk to him with this one character. And he left. And that was just traumatizing. But the difference between those leavings is like, yeah, they're upset, and Solas is upset with you, and you have the confrontation. But he always still, like, respects you, and Blackwall is just a fucking dick to you when it happens. And I just don't feel like any choices you could make in this game warrant the kind of bullshit that he treats you with. So,
well, especially since he's lying and he did horrible things, and, so and you're like,
yeah, he's being hypocritical, and he's
being like a little judgy.
Yeah, he's like, yeah, you don't give a shit about anyone. And how many times in my last playthrough did everybody say to me, well, Solas said it to me, oh, Cole's the worst. He's like, you don't care about people. I was like, oh my God,
that's horrible.
Oh, it's not true. I do care about people. Anyway, so in some way, like, I kind of wish I'd let him leave, though, because anyway, his just in comparison with the others, maybe it's a good voice acting job on that, or maybe it's like too fucking deep, man. Just step back. Step back. It's just not necessary. You don't have to be that mad at me. I don't know. I will have problems with that, because like I said, it was just scary. And
if someone with, like, incredible moral high ground said that to me, I'd be like, okay, all right, yeah, I get
Michelle
it.
Yeah, Michelle Obama tells me, I'm like, oh, okay, you're right. But she would not do it like Blackwall. She would not. But back to DA4, I think a lot of people have agreed on the premise that because, you know, Dorian goes back and he's staying there, his dad died. Once again, this is spoiler, so, you know, you were warned before, but his dad dies. He goes back to Deventer. I think we see some people from the comics in the little outstrip. I don't remember. We stab the map. We are either going to stop Solas through, like, murder or through love. Through love and friendship. Murder. Through love and friendship. Me through love and friendship. with potential, like, grabbing the ear and being like, you fucking idiot. Stop this. Stop it. Stop it.
I know my Inquisitor was very naive at the beginning, and then him leaving hardens her a lot, so I don't know how it's gonna play out. I mean, they may not even touch on it, which will really piss me off.
I feel like it's the opposite with, like, my Solace romance. Sibby, she's very tough in the beginning, like, very hardened and, like, mistrustful. And then as it goes on, she kind of loosens up. And then at the end, she's kind of, like, mushed by the situation. She just completely squashed. Anyway. I know.
Poor baby.
I know. The poor little muffin. She was like, there might be hope in this fucking world. There might be. And then he's like, nope. No, sorry. Sorry. Sorry, darling. Any pets? Sorry. Can you hear that?
Yeah.
that wasn't petting her and then taking her hand.
Doesn't sound like that. It sounds like scraping.
Well, sorry that it doesn't sound. I'm not a sound effect person. Whatever. Interventor, Dorian. What's important to me about DA4 is Dorian fucking living. Because I will not ever forgive anyone who murders Dorian. It's just not happening.
And wait, that is you can not murder compel Dorian? Me. How?
No, I'm saying, no, you can't.
Oh, God. What?
No, you can't murder Dorian. I'm saying if they kill him ever, I'm going to be very upset.
He
better die of natural causes when he's super fucking old with his wonderful husband, whoever that is. Mm-hmm. But I guess before we talk about that, let's talk about the people that, like Alistair Hawk, we already talked about, people that in some variations they died. So mm-hmm. like characters that we won't see again. Iron Bull, we won't see him again. Blackwall, no. We won't see him again.
No.
Sarah can't die, so Cole can't die, right? Or can he? Krim can die, so
yep.
Fuck. We probably won't see Krim. We might in like a probably not though.
I would hope that they would be like, because there are side characters that I really want to see again. Like, I would love to have Krim as a companion. Or
I know, but they just won't. They're not going to do that because he could have died.
Harding would be a great companion.
I know. I'm just thinking of other people that, like, we can eliminate from this process of thinking. Vivian's fine. Liliana can turn into a Lyrium spirit. I mean, I don't think they'll ever get rid of Liliana because I love her and I'm hopeful they don't. Cassandra will still be there.
Mm-hmm.
Who else? I'm walking through Skyhold in my
Varric
head.
Will be there. Well, Varric I don't know if there. They'll use Varric again. I mean, he's been in two games. I would hope they do because I love Varric, but
Varric, I think we'll probably get a cameo. He's really popular and awesome, and I want Varric around.
I do too.
Who else? Who else? I'm just going through. Cullen, we will not see Cullen again. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna be happy about this because I know he's beloved, but I'm not crying about it. It's okay. He's off there with your person, or he died if you're a terrible person and you made him take Lyrium. So sorry.
I do feel bad for him in some respects, and I don't think he's a terrible character or anything, or I don't hate him or dislike him. I just he's not for me. After playing a mage in the first one and then meeting him in the second one, because my Hawk was a warrior, but meeting him in the second one really changed my opinion of him, as we all know.
Yep, but we won't see him again, probably, due to that.
Probably, yeah.
Who else? I'm just mentally going through here. Cullen, Josie, we will probably see Josie. I hope so. Or we'll at the very least hear from her again.
She might be in one of those things where it's like you get a letter and it's from her.
Yep. And I think that's like it from Inquisition. I think. If I'm forgetting. I mean, Sarah, I don't think so. But maybe. I would never eliminate it, but for sure we're gonna encounter Dorian, and hopefully they don't murder him because that would suck.
I want Vivian to show up more because I feel like she wasn't, wasn't really, I didn't feel like she had a lot of banter, but I didn't feel like I really got to know her that well in Inquisition.
No, that was kind of the point. Like, she was supposed to be, like, cold, and I'm like, fuck, what? Mm. Because she's, you know what's funny? I couldn't remember if this was something that always happens, but after I did her Wyvernheart thing or Wyvern or whatever you want to call it, her quest, we bring it to her and she's like, you know, I misjudged you. And I forget if she always did that, if she liked you from the beginning, because she wasn't terribly warm to my last character. So I was trying to remember, but that's really nice, you know, because she's like, you know, I misjudged you. I thought you were something else. And I was like, that's nice. So I don't know if she always does that. I can't remember, but it excited me because I do think that she was a much better character than maybe a lot of people got to see her, especially if you weren't like one of the things that pissed me off. Is that because on my last playthrough, I didn't play terribly into it. I kind of rushed through it. You don't get those enough approval from a lot of people. Like, I didn't get Sarah's cookie scene most of the time. It took me forever. I had to be a kiss ass and romance her to get that on most people because she's very specific about what she likes and stuff like that. Like, not getting to see those scenes without tons of, like, people-pleasing is what kind of annoys me. So and maybe in GA4, they will do something about that because I want to see a lot of scenes and not have to kiss ass exactly and have to look up what she wants, you know? Like, it's not organic for me, especially I think Sarah is one of the characters that just doesn't happen organically with, at least no. In the way I play. Because well, you then, really have to.
If you play as an elf, it's really hard.
Oh, yeah. She just I'm always an elf, so she like always you. Hates me. Oh.
Yeah, right off the bat, she's like, you're too elfy. And it's like, well, okay, sorry. I don't know how to tell you, but
I hate when they give the options to like be like, because we're elves. And she's like, what? And then she's mad at you. I'm like, don't give us options that she's going to hate that we ask. What the hell? You're setting me up to fail because I want to use the dialogue.
Well, that's like all the transphobic, horrible things you can say to Krem. And it's like, I want to talk to Krem, but I don't want to say all this horrible shit.
Every time
to him.
I see those, I'm like, are you? Or like the thing about Dorian, about, you know, being, what is it? Oh, yeah. Actually, no, I was thinking of the Krem ones when you're like, why do you pass as a man? I'm like, what the fuck?
It's like,
I always ignore that. Oh, and I go right ahead to being like, well, who are you as a person, Krem? Let's talk about that. Fuck this. I'm ignoring that. But, okay, let's hone back in on DA4. So we ended it with the idea that we have to stop Solas. But then casually at the end, it's like everybody just, depending on what you do, you probably go back, regardless of whether you're like, well, we're staying with the Inquisition or we're having a small team or whatever you choose to do. It seems like it's not like the focus of your life. And here he just told you that he plans to fucking rip down the veil. And you're just like, I'm going on with my life. Nothing I can do. Nothing I can do. But I'm retired. I got a dog.
I still can't believe that if you romanced Colin, you get a dog and married.
Fuck that. Fuck it all. Fuck. Fuck.
It's just a little unfair. Just saying.
It is. It is unfair.
Like, pick one. You get one. You can have the dog. You can get married.
Yeah. Or, I mean, I think one of the only ones that would have made sense, like, I love that Sarah got married, but I wish Josie, I know we talk about it and everybody's like, oh, she'd want a big wedding, but it's like, that would have been the cutest because hers is like a fucking fairy tale, much more than Sarah. And if you're going by like traditional fairy tale things, they get fucking married. Okay. All right. I'd talk her into it. I'd be like, Josie, listen. It's too much to go back on our boat to Antiva right now. Let's just do this. We got shit to do. We got to go stop Solas. We got to go. All right. Anyway, I still don't get that because I feel like if I had control of the Inquisitor, I wouldn't be sitting back and enjoying my fucking life. I'd be going out and working. I mean, we're not safe. We can't afford to fucking give him 5 years of building up his elven army. Are we fucking kidding? I'm very impassioned about the fact that I don't understand why they would take time off and be like, oh, we're going to retire. We don't have time for that.
Yeah, it didn't make any sense, but
what we do have time for, though, is is to go after Solas. So we presume that it'll be in the Imperium. Whether it will start off there, we don't know. We don't know anything. We know that it would have to do with Teventer because I would assume that's where he's fucking going and that we're going to see the place called Solas. And I'm so excited about that. Like, even just replaying it, I always think, oh, I won't get that into it. But no, I read all the I see all my codexes and I see all the fucking statues and artwork, and I'm just sitting there looking at it like, what does this fucking mean? And I'm listening to all of it and I'm just so excited. I need more. I need more. And I guess we should talk about like protagonist stuff. Like, there's been discussions of like, hey, should it be kind of like Origins? We could choose to play as like maybe a couple types of protagonists, like with different backgrounds. One of which, if it was in Tevinter, then like the slave, we could be a slave during the uprising, which is the only way I would ever want to be a slave. Like, I want to be a part of that. Well, you know what I mean? Not like literally, but in the game as a character, that's super compelling. And a lot of people jump to that conclusion just because if we were in there as, you know, someone that's a part of that society, that's real fucking dark. Like, that couldn't be the only option. Not that everybody's bad, but that it would be better if we were from that, you know, if we were leading that. And then Liliana, we meet, well, not Liliana, but if we met like the Inquisitor, like through Dorian, or if we met Dorian because he was helping us. Oh, there's just so much potential, you know?
You know who I think could show up? Because, I mean, they're directly related to the whole Tevinter, slavery, magic, all that is Fenris. I think Fenris
should show up. Yeah, that's what I was thinking about. Oh, I really hope so. And I hope that his skin color is right.
Oh my God, sorry. Yeah.
That's all I have to do. I would be really, oh God, that would be awesome. I love Fenris. Once again, great voice actor. With Hawk, though, potentially being dead. And if, I don't know how they would deal with that, but I do think that he should be on our council. And he should be there. He's awesome. And he would be fucking interested in it for sure.
Well, that, oh, I would love to see Fenris, you know, 5 years later or however long it's been and where he's at. And even if he didn't romance Hawk, I mean, he's in a much better place
for sure.
Unless your Hawk was an asshole, but, I would assume, like, him having, you know, loyal friendships and meeting people and realizing he can't trust people would put him in a much different... It would be different, and I think it would be really good.
Well, that kind of leads me to wanting Isabella, and then... But that brings in the fear of, like, what if some things that happened in DA4 about her are still treated that way, like... What if they talk about STDs again? I'm just gonna be, but yeah, Fenris for sure. In my heart, Isabella, or someone just as fucking cool, but,
I'd be happy to see Meryl again too.
Oh yeah.
That would be awesome. If it's got to do with elves, I imagine that maybe something with the Alluvians and her comes back.
Yep.
Or,
I mean, we saw her Alluvian in the Crossroads. We saw it.
Stuff. Yeah, exactly. So
that's not done. They haven't forgotten about it.
I feel like Meryl and Fenris are two that are possible candidates to come back at DA4. And Isabella would be cool, but I just don't trust them to do her justice.
I don't trust them either with that, just because I think... Too much. DA2, we should take what we can from it and then leave the rest, as they say in therapy. Yeah. Anyway.
Take what you can and leave the rest.
Take what helps and leave all the fucking junk behind. Anyone from Origins? We already talked about Alistair, probably not.
Not Ogryn. No Ogryn,
Morgan.
Please.
What about Morgan? I mean, do we want to see... I love Morgan. I want to see her forever. That would probably include like a future Kieran. I had at one point talked about, oh, wait, who's the kid in the Alien Edge who is a dreamer or whatever?
I can't remember his name.
There was speculation on whether or not he can officially die, which I don't think he can officially die. I think, oh God, that's what really intrigues me is like, do they call them the dreamers? I'm so bad. I've talked about this so much and yet I forget. But just exploring the origins of that and like,
is it dreamwalkers or fade walkers or dreamers? I don't know.
Fade walkers sounds like something.
I have no actual knowledge. So
I do, and the fact that I'm forgetting, but what Solus is, which is, you know, in your dreams you can actually go into fade. Oh my God, I didn't do any research on it. It's been a while. I've been trying to like cleanse my brain for future thoughts that don't include that. But I had at one point a huge spiel about that. Lots of info. But seeing that kid from the Alien Age again would be awesome, because we know he went to Defender because he needed help, you know, controlling that part of him, because it can be fucking dangerous. You can go into your dreams and murder people, into their dreams, excuse me.
So. And not realize it, or just accidentally do stuff.
Yeah, and that's scary. And that's something I would love to see explored more. I want to fucking see what Abelos was talking about. I want to find out way more about what actually happened in the Civil War between the elves. I want to know. Like, just don't tease me. Give me more. And then that's, I know people are like, I don't want any more elf shit. And it's like, dude, I'm sorry. I can't help it. I love the elves. I'm not saying don't have it be about the dwarven culture, because a lot of that, like you were talking about how you didn't know about the Titans. It's like, I'm fine with that. We got in the DLC, the kind of more about the Titans. We've had a bunch of shit, and those are all linked too. So like, it could be as much about the Titans and the dwarves and because those are very connected. So I want to find out more about that. I want lots of like, if we're going to adventure, like I want to see some fucking shit about elves. Like they took so much from them. I want to see that. I'm just, oh, I can't even put my thoughts into.
Dragon Age elves are the only elves I actually like in fantasy. Like Tolkien elves I find so boring. I'm sorry if you love Tolkien elves. That's cool. I don't like them. You know that Tumblr post where Tolkien is talking to his friend and he's like, I just wrote something. And he's like, oh, cool. Is it about more elves? And he's like, yeah. And he's like, I don't want to read it. That's me. I don't want to read it. Like, no, thank you. I'm okay. That's cool that they live forever. And they're just sort of
that
like.
That is my least, like, that's, that's not as interesting.
They're just, it's, they're out of touch.
Oh, like, hey, what wants about to read about? I know you can kill him though. Oh shit. Never mind.
You can?
Yeah, Morgan can murder him.
Whoa.
It's a fucking dramatic scene. And I took a little pleasure in it, but not much, because I don't have anything against him. I just think those elves are fucking snobs. But whatever. Listen, nothing against you, Abelos. I'm sorry you died that one time at Morgan's hands. It was unfortunate. I apologize. I didn't do the rituals. I'm sorry. Anyway. So definitely more on that. I want to find fucking codexes. I want to find cool fucking shit in Tventor that has to do with the elves that came from there. More about the Titans and that whole situation.
What are the Titans? Please explain it to me, because I don't understand it, and there's no chance that I will ever read about it.
I haven't personally done too much about dwarves. That was actually my next topic. The thing is, that is something I totally am going to do for my own channel that I might like upload here too. I don't know if you want to be here for that, like, basic, because that will be scripted, because this is fucking intense. But to be basic about the Titans, you see them and they're the pillars of the earth. They're ancient beings that dwell deep beneath the earth. And obviously, I've only played that DLC once, but, like, I should totally play it again, because it is one of my, dwarves in general are my weaker, like, lore knowledge. But from what we know, they're shaping the earth. Now, we know that Flemeth killed a Titan. That's like, I think we found that out in Trespasser. There was some stuff when we go in Trespasser, we find some codexes about that. And obviously we saw Valta in the DLC. There's like still fucking a lot that's confusing. That might be even more confusing to me than anything else. People have theorized that the reasons why the Titans and the Pantheon or whatever, what the creators, the Evanuris, that the conflict there with Flemeth is, or Mythal, excuse me, is that the Titans, because they shape the earth and because they have the potential to basically fucking wreck shit up and like kill everyone, that maybe Mythal and everybody wanted to stop them from doing whatever the fuck they needed to do. Like, it's still unclear. We know that Lyrium, we know that Titans are the blighted at this fucking point. Like, that's a thing that happens. And we know that Red Lyrium is basically, well, Lyrium in general is their sort of like their blood, right? Like, runs through them. And then it gets blighted. It's a whole fucking confusing thing, but to condense it, they're just the fucking stone. I mean, and it's confusing. This is something I would have to go into more, because Dwarven stuff is like few and far. There's a lot of it, but at the same time, it's one of the more confusing arenas. And that's why I think they have to dedicate more time to it, because it is hard to understand in some ways. And like, even just looking, not that it's my best resource, but I was on the Dragon Age wiki and there's just like not fucking enough. They're fucking magical as fuck. That's what I got.
They're magical as fuck. But
they're magic. This is old magic. If anyone watches Critical Role, that's like when somebody gets a bad roll on a magical thing, he's like, it's old magic. Arcane check to it's old magic. So guys, I just did a roll in my head and this is old magic. The Titans, they're old magic. But yeah, I want to talk about that though, and I think I could benefit from replaying The Descent. I think, or watching it at least.
Because I never played it. I had trouble getting through the other one.
Dude, you need to watch that. It's really
good. Well, I watched it. I just haven't. Oh, well, I haven't watched Descent, but I.
You need to watch Descent because.
Okay.
It's important. I think it's the only DLC that actually. Well, no, Haken is fucking. I love Haken. I love it so much.
It was really interesting. I liked it a lot. I couldn't finish it because I got stuck in the cave, but.
Really?
Okay. I watched the ending though, so I know what happened.
Out of all the DLC though, if I had to choose between keeping, like getting to play one, Descent is, I think, the only one that I think is going to be critically important to the future. And if it's not, I'm going to be sad. But, yeah. So yeah, but what we know is that the Titans fall and fucking bad shit is up. I'm not getting my hopes up too much about like with Mass Effect and how they actually explain the Reapers. Like, I always get afraid when I start thinking, well, they're going to tie this up. It's like, I don't know. Do they know? Are they just, do someone actually know? Did Gator actually know or whoever? I don't know. But either way, I hope the Titans and all that shit carries over. And that's what I'm most excited about. I mean, future characters, like I've talked about, like I want to see another Grey Warden. As like someone there, I want Dorian around. I don't want it to be like we're fucking chasing Solas. Like, I want it to be like we're actually doing shit. Like, what's happening with the elves that came with him? And I don't want that to be held off for like a bunch of another game. I want to hear about that. Mm-hmm. But I don't want him to be like our foe.
No.
I wanted there to be something bigger than that. I'm trying to think. I always feel like I have more. I mean, other than the general, you know, better hair and like better eyebrows, which is what we always say. And I liked the combat. I think I don't want anything to really change about that other than all minor like fantasy. What else there to talk about?
If they make us go to a ball, I just don't want any more Zap Brannigan, red, stupid, ugly suits. Like, why did they make anybody, like, not even just female Inquisitors, but in general, why did they think, like, we're going to a ball, we're all gonna match in this hideous red outfit?
When you think about that, that's like, if you showed up as that, even as, like, I don't understand. Like, somebody had to sit down and make that. Somebody had to fucking make that model. And to them, I want to say, I'm real sorry if this was what you were given. If this is what you came up with. Why does Morgan get a fucking nice outfit? What the fuck? I love it, but at the same time, I don't know. Again, this is the reason why I'm totally okay with Andromeda needing more time. Whatever. Just don't give me a fucking weird-ass suit thing. With a sash, and I don't know. There's no way to make that pretty. And and even the dress they give you for the wedding is still fucking, like...
Not cute.
Listen, it could be simple. Why did you add all those fucking bolt things and it could be so much simpler. It's like, that's just an area that, like, needs improvement, because...
I don't know. I feel like with Dragon Age and Mass Effect, they just... Civilian clothing, they don't know what the hell they're doing. It's like, they're like, well, I understand armor, so if we just make it a bodysuit,
I know. Be easier. Do you know what's really upsetting to me is that when I see, like, a character that's in the middle of fucking nowhere that's wearing a really cool outfit that I don't see anywhere else. And all I can think is that you had to make that outfit that, like, a couple characters in game wear, and we don't get to wear it. And ours looks like this. This one, Lenny had like a wolf pelt over her one time. And when I saw it, I was like, where did you get that? Like, who made this for you? Wait a minute. Really? Really? We're dedicating all this time to side characters wearing this outfit? Or like little characters we pass by that sell hats and they're wearing this really awesome outfit and I'm wearing this? And then these ladies at the ball get all these outfits? Morgan gets this outfit? Celine gets this outfit? And what about me? Do you even care about me?
You get to look like Zap Brannigan with pants.
You don't care about me is what I'm saying, BioWare. You don't care about my desire to possibly wear a dress.
Just something that hideous is honestly all I'm asking for.
I do question again, who the fuck is in charge of that? And I just have hope that they're bringing in people who now are going to be like, listen, I just have been meaning to tell you that this, we need to, you know, but that would be a weird position to be in, you know, but at the same time, I think someone needs to say it. And if you're not reading or like hearing us about it, then that's just... That's my input, but that's what it always comes back to, because it's just like there's no reason behind it, because if you're going to take time to do that, but you have to, why it can't be somewhat okay? You don't have to make it complicated. A simple fucking dress that doesn't have sleeves that are disconnected and rejointed on the shoulder with a lining. Help me.
The other thing that made me so mad is I remember when they were like, oh, there's a ton of crafting and you can make your own outfits and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, oh, boy, this is going to be great. And then you get in there and you can make like tartan plaid hideous things and none of them have very good stats, even if you put in extra stuff. I couldn't even really figure out the crafting because it was so confusing. And I just like either simplify it or take it out because you didn't do a great job. It wasn't great.
That system does need a little bit of help.
And the yellow tartan plaid? Why?
Like, reasons. Reasons.
Why? And then you couldn't really make anything like that wasn't sort of dingy looking other than the yellow tartan plaid. Mm-hmm. But
there's some silky ones, but...
Yeah.
In my last game, I had Dorian, Varric, and Vivian, all in that Tevinter garb from the DLC, you know, that Calpurnia wears. And it was cool. All in different colors. And I gave Varric a yellow version, and I named it Banana Dwarf. and Vivian, I think, Dorian was in all whites and some silky silver, of course. And Vivian had, like, some purples because it looked really great on her. Anyway, they were my crew, and here I was in my armor, and I was like, let's go, crew. This is how they know we're together, because you're matching, and I'm in my plate, and it weighs like a fucking 100 pounds, this plate. That's a problem, too, for me, is like, proportionately on my elf, because they're so fucking tiny, their models are just so tiny, that like, seeing them in the armor is just... Fantasy or not, there's some disbelief on my end when I see like 100 pounds of, not 100, but you know, it's really heavy. It's just heavy. It's huge. And I just think they should fit it better to the models too. More time on stuff like that is what I hope is that they spend more time on that. Cause I want to be able to play it on my PS4. I don't want to have to mod it always, you know, I want some decent eyebrows and a ponytail that doesn't have little wispies on the side. And I want
bangs would be nice, like just different kinds of bangs or different textures of hair.
Curly hair. I don't have to be fucking fancy. I don't know.
Curly hair would be
nice.
I know it's hard,
but I just, and it's worth spending the money on it, BioWare. It is. I promise. Well,
that, and I also just wish they would come up with like, okay, so they've got the elf, dwarf, human, and canary body type, right?
Oh,
so
yeah, that's,
why can't we have just like two or three versions of each body type?
The fat elf. Fat elf. Hashtag fat elf.
I just want like some variation, because I understand that it's hard to map them and stuff for love scenes and just in general. But if you could just give like a little variation for each one, I think that people would just feel a little less frustrated. And also it would make... Because, I don't know, I just would prefer it. It would make me feel, like, happy if I could at least make, like, a fat elf or...
True. Very true.
I don't know.
Because there's no, you can't get skinnier than the elves that you are.
Oh my God.
Yeah. It bothers me on a level when you see the sentinels.
Well, it doesn't even look real. It looks like they literally took the elves, human
they are, and they their just squished thighs it. Are fucking, their thighs don't make any sense to me. And like a lot of people mm-hmm. are like the dude elf thighs that you see in that armor. It's so intense. The fucking thigh gap. It's not even like a, they're just so skinny and I get it. They have different body types apparently. I don't like it. I don't think it's, but I wanted to get us onto something that's kind of more directly about DA4, which is like we could play as Kunari, dwarf, human, or elf. So do you think we'll still have those options in DA4? Or will, I don't know. What are you thinking?
I don't know. I think it depends on the way they're going. I know for sure we'll probably be able to be an elf or a human. Dwarf,
The thing about it, for a while I was confused because the dwarves have a this is the reason they'll be in the game a lot too, is the dwarves have been allied with Teventer for a fucking long ass time. And they they have consulate's the wrong word, but they have their own, like, because they have to stay underground, most of them, or all of them there, they have their, really, they build them, states is still the wrong word, but whatever, they have places there that they live, and there's ambassadors, and they have a really close relationship. So, that was my question that I didn't understand about Teventer and their system, their slaves, is anyone can be a slave, and I thought for a while that because they were so closely allied with dwarves and it was really important to trade and everything that I didn't think they could be, but they can. Anybody can be a slave, apparently, in their culture. I thought there was, like, off limits, but no. So it totally leaves it open to, if you were playing as a slave who escaped slavery, could totally be any of them. Practically, though, I do kind of think, I don't know. Everybody, there are people that really love dwarves and people who really love Kunari. And it wouldn't make sense to exclude elf. So 100% we can play as an elf. If we couldn't, I'd be like, are you kidding me? That we're in Teventer and they, like, apparently, according to history, their history anyway, they're responsible for, like, Arlathan's fall and all that shit. So definitely an elf. You can assume definitely a human because humans. I'm not sure about dwarf or Kunari. Like, it stands to reason that they'll stay with that system to me, but I wouldn't be shocked if they didn't,
Yeah. I feel like with the way the story is going to go, if you were to be a Kunari, well, maybe if you were a mage or, I don't know. I mean, I think they might include all four just because they already did it with Inquisition, but then at the same time, I kind of wonder if they're going to do, which I don't want them to do this, but I kind of wonder if they're going to do something like what they do with Hawk, where you could only be a human. I'm wondering if they would do that with the elves.
No,
if it's to do with the elven, like,
not.
I hope not too, because I love elves, or I love Dragon Age elves.
I think people
will
be mad about that, because there is a bunch of people who are like, we're done with you elf lovers. And I'm like, I don't understand. I mean, I hope I'm not one of those people that makes people go, well, I'm done with you, elf lover. But it's like, I get it, or maybe I don't. It's just, it is true that, like, from the way I play, I do love elves. I'm obsessed with elves, and they're what I'm there for. So, I don't know. I guess some people get, because if they prefer, like, humans, dwarfs, whatever, and they don't get that attention, but it's like, the humans, they don't have, like, that much. Like, I get it being, like, I want more Kunari focus, because there's not as many Kunari nearly as humans. But with humans, like, there's so many humans, and I don't know. I don't feel like humans are underrepresented, and, yeah, I don't know.
I
feel like dwarves are underrepresented.
Yeah, I would like it if they had more interesting stuff for the dwarves, because I feel like theirs is always really limited and their romances are always super limited, which is not fair. And I hope they don't do only elves, because that'll piss me off.
Oh my God, can you imagine if we were a fat dwarf? Sliders on that? Oh my God, that would be great. Whoa. I want to be a little fat dwarf baby.
It would even be nice if they did it like...
I'm so sorry.
A little fat baby dwarf. I mean, I would even be happy if they just did, like, you could be more or less muscular or...
Yeah.
Fatter, thinner. It's... I just...
Just give me a couple options. Nice. Give me a couple.
Because it also bothers me that all the people in the world are all thin, too. Like, there's no body variation at all, except for...
Nobody is visually impaired. Apparently, yeah,
exactly. No,
it's and apparently, magic. Yeah,
no glasses, which doesn't make any sense, especially in like a medieval world.
You're screwed out there if you can't see. You're screwed.
In Mass Effect, I get it because it's like, all right, there's probably biotic enhancements, there's probably things like that. But at the same time, I'm Vetra, like, not everybody Mass can probably
is visually impaired. That's our little thing. No, I don't
know. We don't know. We don't know.
She could be.
I just want some variation. I mean, is it so much to ask?
No, it's not. And it's just like a time thing that they just have to, once again, prioritize if they're going to do like a bajillion quests that are pointless or narrow it down to and hone in on those quests and make them maybe a little deeper and more meaningful. And then maybe you'll have time and money to hire someone to, you know, come in on those things and get advice and do better. And they're getting better as time goes on in some ways. So I don't know. I'm just excited about it. And I just kind of, I'd be okay. What about the game title? What do we think of, what are they going to call it? I know that would greatly depend on if they end up actually, which I don't see why they wouldn't, but if they ended up going to Deventure and all that, I think there has been like some fake titles posted online because I get news updates about it. And like, but I mean, they're going to stick with the format, I would assume, of Dragon Age. Blank. Dragon Age. We're fucked.
Dragon Age Eggs Benedict.
Yeah, that's a good
Dragon
one.
Dragon Age.
Delicious.
Scrambled eggs. Dragon Age Escape from Deventer.
Yep. Yep, Dragon Age Uprising, Dragon Age.
Yours are more realistic, mine are more just
I know, stupid. You're better, I'm not. I'm just thinking stupid. Like real, I'm like, Dragon Age, Dragon Age.
Big Trouble and Big Deventer.
Yep. I like yours better. If they did Eggs Benedict, that would be cool, because first of all, I'm hungry now.
Mm-hmm.
Let's Same. Think, yeah, anything I'm else to too. Expand on here? I mean... Like we said, we don't have confirmation. We've seen like some teasing from, I think Mark Dara teased it. Like a pawn chess thing, chess piece with like a wolf, which is like nothing new. Okay. I just hope it's not like Wolf Hunt. Oh my God. Because I hope it's not all about Solas. And I hope that it's not like all about something else. Because I hope, oh God.
Well, did you see they had an analysis on the teaser he did. Let me look it up.
Oh yeah. While you're looking for that, I will say that Alexis Kennedy, I kind of talked about this on my channel once, but Alexis Kennedy is the guy who did Fall in London and that one game that I can never remember, Sunless Sea, I think. And he's a great writer and I like him a lot, and he was another proof that they're actually doing it, is he was hired to help on something for them. I don't know if it's a book or something, but he was hired. And so if they're hiring people for Dragon Age stuff, there's going to be a Dragon Age. Yeah. I think after Andromeda is out, it'll be a thing. And then, of course, begins the new IP stuff, which I don't know what they'll do first, if they'll talk about the new IP or that or both.
I know I posted it. I can't find it anywhere. Let's see.
It's a Reddit thread and it says, Mark Dara is such a tease. And it's a list. Dragon Age Deventer Empire, Dragon Age Minrathus Knights. Damn, I like acronyms. If they called it Dragon Age Deventer Empire, I'd be... I think it's a joke, but he was trying to make the acronym DAM and DATE. He was trying on acronyms for game titles. Mark, what the fuck? If that is real, I can't find it on his thing, but...
I can't find the thing, but basically, from what I remember, it just... Apparently the significance, there's a significance with where the chess piece and what type of chess piece it is, where it is on the board.
I thought it was a pawn. It was on a board? Hold on a minute. Mm-hmm. The last picture noticeably references a video of an internal Dragon Age book with a rook on the front, shown by Mark Dara back in May.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, a decent speculation is that this book, The Tower, references Solas as he delves into chess during the course of Inquisition and is represented by the Tower tarot card. Yeah. Make or preserve us. But the position of the tower on the chessboard, the bottom right pick, is E3.
Yeah, that was it. That was it. It's E3. And so we're supposed to get a...
He said, okay. Honest to God, I had no idea the rook was on E3 when I posted this. You are all amazing and frightening. So, yeah.
Well, they better do it anyways. And whose Tumblr was that on? Lady Insanity's?
Yep, Lady Insanity. I forget who... I don't know who the original poster is. Probably someone on Twitter, but I got that off Lady Insanity. So whoever noticed that, awesome.
I don't know if it's true, since he was like, oh, I didn't notice, but I'm going to just pretend that it's real.
Maybe he didn't. Whatever. E3 like E3, right? Sorry.
Yeah.
Okay, good. I'm like, is there enough E3? Yeah, like, that's what we're at. I mean, that's not such a... It's weird, but I guess I could believe. Okay, so I'm trying to think if there's anything else, because I don't want to, like, miss it. Hopes for better... Female romance is always my thing. I will always say that. So that's just assumed. Mm-hmm. And I hope that we kind of like start out. I hope the prologue is like lengthy, you know?
Yeah.
Because I feel like one of the things that suffered for Inquisition, even though it was like cool to find out, oh, okay, this is what happened, you know? I just kind of would like to get a basis of, especially in that kind of life, like I want to add some... feeling to it of like, well, this has been our fucking life. And
you know what I wonder is I wonder if there's going to be some overlap from Inquisition. Like maybe we pick up right after Inquisition ends and we see like some of or like right before Trespasser ends. And so we see him like gathering his people and maybe that's how it. I don't know.
To be honest, I don't want to see him in the intro at all. I don't want it to be about him. I want it to be about, like, what's going on with whoever our protagonist is and Deventer. The situation. Yeah, the Deventer situation. And like, focus on that and, like, I don't know. Like, I think of Origins. I always think of Origins and be like, well... some stuff not great. Like, I don't... There's so much fucking rape stuff that it just... It's upsetting, but surely
City they Elf,
could,
yeah.
They could, yeah, and even when you're a Duckin or not a Duckin, what's the other one? Whatever, I'm so sorry, I can't remember. But when you're a dwarf, it's like, there's so many rapey shit. Oh my God, it's horrible. It's horrible, and I can't remember about the other ones, but it's just not good. But I want that to be a focus of like where we were before and where we are now. And that's not phrased correctly. I'm tired.
We've been talking a long time. It's understandable.
Where we are now. Since we could take apart the Inquisition, essentially, like, I don't think that's going to be much of a fucking thing. But probably seeing people... I hope that whoever was divine, like, we get at least some correspondence with them. That's sad, though, because, like, I feel like Cassandra, even when she's divine, like, I hope she still is a part of, like, the future and stopping shit from going belly up. Because I love her, and I don't want her thrown away. Out of all the characters, I guess it would be a good question to answer is, like, if you could only pick... one that we see again, like Varric, at least as in comes around. I mean, we got Dorian, so that's like our one. And if that doesn't happen, that's going to be crazy because, yeah, that would make no sense. But for me, I think it'd be Cassandra because I think there's enough for her to do. And yeah, what do you think?
From Inquisition or from any of them?
I'm going to say Inquisition specifically because I would have a hard time believing that many people from Origins.
Other than Solas and...
Dorian.
And Dorian.
Hmm.
I want to see Cassandra, yeah. I mean, I don't want to just be like, yeah, same, but yeah.
It's reasonable, I think. It's not that she's... I think it's the most reasonable one to me, so that's why I'm kind of just going realistic here for a change.
Well, that in my playthrough, Liliana is divine, so...
Yeah, me too. Which is the best option, everybody? No. I mean, it is. For me, it is, because if she's not hardened, because if she's hardened, things might go badly.
Yeah.
I accidentally, like, every time I seem to accidentally make Liliana divine, even when I think I'm not going to, because I guess I'm just that kind of a player. Even when I'm making different choices, she ends up divine. Oh, God.
Yeah, I've never
one time she was hardened and I was like, oh, shit, this was a mistake. I didn't mean to. But as long as she's softened, things go well. And, like, mm-hmm. I have the fear, though, whoever it is going to get fucking murdered.
Yeah, so I worry about that.
Oh, boy. Lyrium Ghost Liliana, fare thee well. Fare thee well. I hope, you know, I always want to see her again. Like, she's important to me, and I don't want her gone, so.
I agree.
I should have included, did I include Liliana on my list for underserved characters? Or maybe, I don't want to say she's underserved, I want to say that she's, like, misunderstood. You know what I mean? She's misunderstood. Anyway, I think that's it, though. I think this was more tirade than I thought it would be on this subject. But maybe someday we'll have more to discuss on this, I hope. E3? Huh?
Hmm? Hmm? We can hope.
It's time for our plug. So what's your plug, Becca?
Well, I'm going to plug some artists on Tumblr that I like.
Ooh.
So my first Tumblr artist that I'm going to plug is Limp Stella.
Mm.
Her name is Lisa, and she's very talented, and I really like her art, and she bought one of my Inktober originals, and she draws a lot of Dragon Age, and you should check them out at limpstella.tumblr. And then another one that's really good is Avinox. AVINOX at Tumblr. Very talented.
I think they follow me.
Probably. I mean, I follow them, and I think most of them follow me. I think we're mutuals. I don't know. It doesn't really matter. I'm still going to plug them. And then I'm pretty sure Shirl and Avinox are friends, but Shirl, S-H-I-R-R-I-L-L, at Tumblr.com is also very talented. They are all three of them, very talented. They do Mass Effect and Dragon Age, and I think... some other things, but that's mostly what I follow them for, and they're just very talented. You should check them out.
Those are good ones. Mine aren't as deep. I guess my plug for this week is going to be Moana, because I fucking loved it. Lin-Manuel Miranda did some of the writing on the music, and it's just a really good movie. I really loved it. I thought the music was awesome, and Moana is just... it's just great, and I love it, and watch it. And you didn't do your unplug, so what's your unplug?
My unplug is Tolkien elves. I just don't like them.
Understandable, but
zero,
you know,
stars.
They can be a little sexy. That's all I'm going to say. Sometimes, but I'm not into it either. I kind of struggled. I love Toriel, though. Is that how you say her name? But I love her, so that's all I can think of in terms of that, because... fucking character, just, it's so sad. But and I guess my unplug would be your toxic masculinity, if I could say it.
Yeah, toxic masculinity.
Toxic masculinity is my unplug, because sucks. That's what we were feeling this week. So so I think this has been okay. We didn't have much to go on, so this was a lot of ranting, which I think I disclosed, but either way, sorry. I hope it was okay to listen to, and if it wasn't, then, you know, stuff. You can find us on Twitter at Ginger and Red Hot. And my places you can find me personally, Elven Tempest on YouTube, Twitter, and my Tumblr is thetempest.tumblr.com. Becca?
You can find me on glitterfang.tumblr.com for my art, and on Twitter you can find me at glitterfangart. And that's pretty much the only places you can find me.
And I'm hiding. Indeed. And our question or thing we want us to tweet you at Ginger and Red Hot, tell us.
We want you to tweet us.
Yeah, you tweet us at Ginger and Red Hot. Tweet Becca. She will respond to you. Probably. Tweet her the thing that would most excite you to see in Dragon Age 4. The most exciting, because we'll be positive, because there's like a lot of like negatives lately, so just give us a positive, something that would be like the best if you saw it in Dragon Age 4.
Your little heart would just explode.
It would explode. At Ginger and Red Hot, send it to us what you would love in Dragon Age 4. One thing. Just pick one, because, you know, you could probably go on forever, but just one. Mm-hmm. And that's it for us. We're going to go now. We're going to go. See ya.
We're going to go.
Bye.
I should go. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.